Hello, and welcome to Kraaft It Live. It is the top of the hour. That means we have to go live. I know because Debbie's here cracking the whip and telling me what I need to do. So so thank you, Debbie.
You're welcome.
So Debbie, do you want to say hi? I'm going to put you on camera. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. And you know what? And then, Heather, take me off camera and let me talk without popping the camera because you know how I am.
I do know.
But hi, everybody. Good to see you.
And do you know that I had forgotten to turn the screen to one box so that way the people out there could see the whole box? I'm surprised nobody's yelled at me yet. So anyway, all right, we're good to go. So yes, the camera is now on me, Debbie. You're fine. You can do whatever you want to do, eat your cereal and all that. Nobody will know. So we have a lot of things going on this month as far as the theme for this month. I don't know if you've noticed, but I've been trying to do themes each month. And last month we did stamping, and the whole month was all about stamping. And this month it's all about altering. And we are going to be altering today a mirror, which I was inspired by Peg Robinson. I'm not sure if you have seen some of the work that she's done, but she's an excellent artist, and she does some great work. And she had, I think, in a time when we were all hanging out together, you know, because we do that sometimes. We hang out together as a community. And she was actually putting together some mirrors for her son, I believe. And I kind of drooled over what she was doing. And I thought, you know, out of all the projects I could do this month to alter something, because it's pretty vague, right? I mean, altering something.
Something.
I know, something. I really wanted to alter a mirror in the same fashion that she did. And then I happened to be at a local thrift store here, and I found a mirror, which is just literally, it's a frame with a glass mirror inside. That's all it is. And it was like $1.99, and I thought, here we go. So today's show is inspired by Peg Robinson, and I will try really hard to get, I should have done this before we went live, but try to get her website, her blog that we could link to so you could go check out some of her work. And I'd really like to start doing more of that if we could focus more on the community members and what a lot of those talents are out there. And maybe each episode we could feature one of them and give some props to their blog. What do you think about that, Debbie?
Well, here, what do you think about this, Heather? How about I go get that link to her website, and I'll get it in the comment box here. How about that?
All right, that's a great idea. I should have thought of that. You go ahead and do that then.
All right.
All
Sounds
right.
Sounds good.
So before we head on over to the workstation, where I have some things set up that I want to show you, I would like to talk about today's message, and I'll just go ahead and read that for you. And I appreciate, Debbie, you typing that in for me so I could get the other work done. But I think I just got rid of it. So you can click it, please.
All righty. Let me go back and find it. Yeah, and if anybody was watching, it only took me 4 tries to get it in there because I had typos and whatnot. I'm looking for it now because we had it marked.
I know we had it marked, and I hit the wrong thing. I didn't eyeball it. I start it.
Here we go. I got it.
This is why I don't run the comments. You do.
I run the comments. Can you see it now?
I do. Thank you very much. Oh, it's so good to have you here. Today's message, you armed me with strength for battle. You make my adversaries bow at my feet, Psalm 18:3. And I've got to tell you guys that it's actually 1839, but I've got to tell you guys that here it is. It is Tuesday, November 11th. And this is the day that we in America set aside to honor our veterans. And I know we've got a lot of folks who have served. We even have Jay in our membership, who in our community membership, who has served. And I just want to say thank you to those of you whose family members, the family that has served. I just want to thank you all because it is a big deal to have freedom, and it is because of you and your sacrifices. So I thank you for that, and I'm sure we all say thank you. And I just wanted to make sure that you knew that. And today's message kind of fit into it. God has a pretty good plan when he does stuff like that. So without further ado, I'm going to just switch over to the camera scene. If you've got some comments you want to bring on screen, Debbie, now would be a good time to do that.
Alrighty then. This comment is not going to fit on the screen. It's from Sylvia, who's not in the room with us. She normally is. but it's her firstborn grandson's birthday, and he's 16. Yes, already grown up. I know, Sylvia, it happens so fast. But so anyways, we're missing you, Sylvia, but we know that you're here in spirit. So
just and I will tell you that that entire comment, that entire comment was on the screen because business hangouts.
And I lost your audio, so I hope everybody else heard that.
Okay. So, any others that you wanted to share?
You know what, I just wanted to mention, this is actually my own comment, but I wrote it to remind myself that you showed me already the Kraaft Shaak drawing November prize, which is very cool. So let's be sure that we talk about that. But this month, the challenge is to alter something. So take notes while you watch Heather today. She's altering something, and that will be your entry for this month.
Okay. So what I did want to share with you is that I am going to be using alcohol inks today. That's going to be my coloring. And before I start, can you see my fingers? This is after I clean them. They're pretty messy. So just to be aware, here's something I wanted to share with you, because when I pulled out all of my alcohol inks today, they were atrocious. They were a huge mess. It was disgusting, actually. And I took the time and cleaned all of them except for this one, because it occurred to me you might want to know how to clean your alcohol inks if they became really icky messy like mine did. So what I wanted to share with you is all you need is a bottle of alcohol, rubbing alcohol, and some paper towels. And you might want to put gloves on so you don't end up like this, but you know me, I won't do it. So I just take the lid off, and if you're going to do all of them, I took the lids off and I just kind of set them together. It doesn't really matter too much, but I did learn some things about my caps that I clearly mix and match my caps, and you'll probably see it with this one, but we'll just get to it. So put some alcohol on the paper towel. I use this paper towel to just kind of hold my stuff. It did get messy after a little while. And you can use your craft mat, a no-stick craft mat, if you want, because that does help protect your surface, and then things just wipe right off of it. But, you know me. I make a mess, and why pretend otherwise, right?
Well, so and here's a note from Michael. I love the messy fingers. Please drop something now.
Yeah, he's a character. Thanks, Michael. I'll do my best just for you. All right, so all I'm doing is just adding more alcohol, and I'm just wiping off the outside. As you can see, it's pretty stubborn. And you notice this one is called butterscotch, and look at all that green. Clearly, I have used the other cap on here, but it never messed with the color inside. It only put a bunch of green on the outside of this bottle. That's all it did. So, as you see, the paper towel that I'm cleaning it with is just coated in green.
And what were you saying about rubber gloves?
Yeah, exactly. That's my point.
Hey, listen, I want to say, we've got a room full here. Andrew is here, and Michael, Nanette, and Susan. I just want to read everyone off. Tina, and Sandra, Kathy, Sherry, Victor, Patty, Rose Treasures, Patty, Lon, and Clubcraft. Clubcraft is here from Facebook.
Cool, cool, cool. I think so, I don't know. I'm not positive, but I think that's Allie Cutter.
Oh, okay. All right. So, hey, everybody. Nice to see y'all.
I could be wrong, and if I'm wrong, I hope she will correct us. Me, because I'm the one who's wrong. But
well, go ahead, Clubcraft. Leave us a note in the message box here in our unified chat and let us know.
It might be Kristen.
All right. We haven't seen
her in a while. I know that much. All right. Here, I'm just going to put some in the cap. Can you see that I put some in the cap there? I'm just going to kind of roll it around and get that all liquidy in there. I'm going to grab one more paper towel. And I'm going to take the corner and stick that down inside. And twist it around. And you're going to see all of that green come out of there, because this was the green cap, the green-colored alcohol ink cap, but I mix them up all the time. That's pretty obvious now. Look at that.
Eek!
Yeah, I know. You might want to do this a little bit more often than I have. This makes you not want alcohol inks, I'm sure, but here's the key. And you guys will love me for this. I let kids play with my stuff. You might not. This might be why you wouldn't.
Hey, that's guess what?
It is Kristen.
It is Kristen. Kristen is here from Club Kraaft. Okay, that's pretty
cool.
She's
joining us from Facebook. That's why it's saying Club Kraaft. That's pretty cool.
Oh, I see. Okay. So if you're watching this on...
Go ahead.
If you're watching this on YouTube and you're wondering where we're getting all these comments from, come over to the Kraaft Shaak website, KraaftShaak.com. I think it's in the details of the YouTube here too. And you click in on the Watch It Live tab where we're having a conversation and everyone's kind of just hanging out and being us.
Very cool. Very cool. Okay, so what I'm going to now that I've cleaned up all of my everything except for my fingers. Look at, I'm even dirtier now than I was. Okay. All right, so a couple of the products that I'm going to be using for this next step, we're still not even touching the, this is going to be done in stages because I got to wait for things to dry, you know? So we're going to do this part, which seems to be like an end of the thing part, but we're going to start it now. So I've got 3D gloss gel. This is part of the Art Basics line from Finnebear. And of course you can buy this in the store. And some of you actually have already purchased this in the store. So I am just going to put together some of that into a little solo cup. And about that much. I don't think I'll need much more than that. But here's the neat thing about these solo cups. I put the lid on and save it for later if I don't use it all. So actually, I might even just mix a little bit more now that I think about that.
Now, are you just recycling those from, like, carry-out food, or do you buy those cups?
I bought them. I did buy them.
Okay.
All right, and then I'm going to take this one is called Watermelon, this alcohol ink. And I'm going to put in, I think, 2 drops.
This is going to look like frosting, and it's going to make me hungry. They're already talking about Red Lobster over here in
Unified
Chat.
Well, that's Sylvia's fault, because Sylvia's taken her son to Red Lobster, or grandson to Red Lobster, so it's all her fault. All right, and then I have another product called Art Sugar. This is that ultra-fine glitter, and this one is in the pink, and I'm putting... an ample amount. Can you see that, how much I put in there?
Yeah, and again, making me hungry.
I know, it does look like sugar. It really does. It's very fine glitter. All right. Now I'm just going to use another spatula and mix it all up. So do you have some more comments you want to share?
Yeah, Andrew is, you know Andrew. He's always trying to help us out. He wants to know if you can't color code the tops so that you can get them back on the right bottoms.
That would be a good idea. Yeah, I probably could. Will I, though? That's always the question.
Yeah, I try to do that with my acrylic paints because the tops are white, and then I can just put a little dot on the top and then stack them into a drawer and still know what's in there.
Yeah,
so,
that's smart.
Yeah. And then... let's see, that we've got Michael here just wishing everybody a happy Veterans Day. So if you're watching the recording of this, it is November 11th, 2014, and today is Veterans Day that we're recording the live version here.
All right, I'm looking at this, and I'm seeing it's pink. I like that. It is got some... Here's the hard part about doing this. I know there's glitter in there because I put it in there, but I can't really tell... and I probably won't be able to tell until it is dry. So, I think we're going to call it good. It's pretty well mixed. And one of the things I really wanted to show you guys is that you could mix your alcohol inks with your gloss gel, and it will not break down or change the viscosity of that. So, kind of cool.
Viscosity?
That's a word I used, yep.
Uh-huh. Could you translate, please?
The the thickness and the elasticity of it. It's basically the same as it was before I added the color.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Oh, and then Susan R., she comes up with this really great idea. She says she stores her bottoms up. Makes
that's
it easy to see the color.
Yep. That way I can...
Well, as long as we're sharing some tips here, Susan also suggested that you change your pillowcase every day because she knows you haven't been feeling good, and your cold will go away faster.
Oh, that's actually a really smart idea. I like that.
That's
and
a good idea.
I like fresh sheets too, so I really like that idea. Okay, so now what I'm going to work on, here's the mirror that I took out of the frame, okay? And I've got a piece of paper on it so that way you don't see the camera shown back at you or the big bright lights or anything. But basically, I took the mirror out. This is the back side of the mirror and this is the front of it. And I am going to move it, move the paper. So hopefully we'll be able to do this and it not be a glaring, horrible view for everybody. But I want to use the mixture that I just made and this stencil. And this one is called Lace, I believe. And these are available in the store as well.
Yeah, in fact, a lot of the products that you're using today are in the store, so when it's convenient, I'll pop over there and just scroll through inventory. But yeah, this is the Lace stencil.
Okay, and what I'm doing here, I know you can't really tell because of this darn light. Let's see. Does that help? Not much. Okay, what I'm doing is I'm lining up the edge of the stencil here on the corner because I'm just going to be putting some of this paste down in the corner, so you'll see what I'm doing here. I've got my palette knife and the mixture we just made. Mirrors on camera, not a good combination. All right, and I'm just going to spread this on, and because this is that 3D gloss gel, it holds its shape so well, so it's not going underneath the stencil at all, really. And it's holding shape, so it's going to be dimensional, which is really cool if you think about that. And I am just wanting it to go in this corner here. It does seem like frosting at the moment. Is everyone holding their breath, or is it just me?
I am kind of holding my breath because you know what happens for me is I move the stencil by accident.
Yeah, it's not moving because this stuff is so thick.
Oh.
I'm just very lightly coating the thing. I'm not being very aggressive with it because this stuff is really thick, really, really thick. I mean, look how it holds that shape in the cup.
Yeah, yeah. So that is, Andrew has given us the technical term, the technical translation of viscosity.
Okay, ready?
Gooiness.
Gooiness, got it. Thank you. I knew he would be there for us. Okay, so now I have gone over the edge, of course, of my mirror, so I want to clean that up while it's still wet. Do it just like this. You guys are getting a bird's eye view of the setup, in case you were wondering. Hello. All right, so I'm going to set this aside to dry. That's what we're doing with that. It's going to go aside to dry.
Hopefully. How long will that take to dry, do you think?
Well, I don't know. I'm thinking quite a while, actually. It does matter on how thick you make it and what it's like in your home. And at the moment, you may even hear the heater kick on when it kicks on. But we are freezing cold outside. So my inside is as warm as we can get it. All right, now I've just got that piece of paper I had on the mirror, and I'm just going to wipe off the rest of that was on the stencil. We use this for another project, huh?
Oh, I see what you're doing.
All right, this is part of the cleanup. Yeah, so that's part of the cleanup, and it's just a very light thin film is on there now, and I've got a bucket behind me because remember I don't have a sink down here, so this is my makeshift sink, and I just splashed it into the bucket. So there we go. We will be using this later. Okay?
Looks pretty good, yeah.
Yeah. All right. And now I still some of this gooiness left, and I can just pop the lid on that and play with it later. I'll probably want to make sure I write the color name and that it's gloss on the outside of it, but basically saved for later. And I think you were asking me where I get those, and I don't know if I
have. We have a lot of people. Yeah, you said that you bought them, but folks here said they're really cheap. The Dollar Store and Walmart, Dollar Tree. Yeah, Dollar Tree and Walmart.
Yeah, my Dollar Tree didn't have any of these, but I did find these in the party aisle at Walmart. They had something like 25 of them with lids. And you can go to any kind of box store like or Sam's Club or anything like that. They sell them in the bazillions, so maybe you and a few friends could go in on them if you wanted to buy them really cheap.
Yeah, you know, I get my meals from Blue Apron, and a lot of the condiments and stuff are packaged in those. And I've got a whole stack of them.
Exactly. That's okay. There you go. There's your answer. You just go to Debbie's house and get them from her.
I got a bunch of them.
Okay, so now for the next portion of this altered mirror, which we did see the mirror, I did alter it, but now we're going to alter the frame some. And to do that, I've taken some heavy-duty aluminum foil, just showing it here, heavy-duty, let's see, does it say it? Yes, aluminum foil heavy-duty, and I've just torn off some pieces, and I did a bunch of them in advance. You're welcome, Andrew. So this is the last one I have to do, and I'm trying really hard to not glare you with this metallic finish, but I also have some waxed paper that I've taken a piece off, folded it in half. I lay the aluminum foil in between the two wax paper sheets, and then run it through my embossing folder. And I've chosen two embossing folder patterns today. So here it is, wax paper in there. And we're going to run it through the Cuddlebug machine or whatever machine it is that you use for your embossing and die cutting. And then when I pull it out, it will be embossed, and it will be embossed metal, which is really fun. So here's what's also neat is that the wax paper is also embossed, and I'm sure if Sylvia was watching, she'd have an answer for us what we could do with that, but maybe one of you guys do. Anybody watching have an idea of what to do with that? Can you see the embossing on there?
Well, that looks very cool.
It is very cool, but it's going to get cooler, okay? So let's set this aside. So there's the embossed wax paper. I know I'm not getting rid of that. Now I'm going to take those alcohol inks again, and I'm going to work today with just two colors, but I don't remember what the colors were. Maybe they are that watermelon that we had before and sailboat blue. And because I'm using two primary colors, I'm actually going to end up with a third secondary color. So even though I'm only using two alcohol inks, we'll have three color scheme going on. That's a good way to stretch your products, too, if you think about it. So here I've got just a small piece of felt. You can buy these pre-cut like this, or you can make your own. Just take a piece of craft felt and cut it into a rectangle. And if you don't have yours made by the ink block like I did, that even have my Craft Shaak name on them, isn't that cool? That's if you don't have cool. those, you can buy them from Inkcentials. They make them. They're just the Ranger Inkcentials ink block blending tool. You put your piece of felt on there, and we're going to take one color and splatter it on my finger. Okay, and then I'm just going to lightly go over the foil and get those raised areas.
So Nanette suggested that maybe jelly print on the embossed wax paper. Would that work?
Ooh, I don't know. All right, that's not giving me enough color for what I wanted. I think I'd like to also zoom in. What do you think of that?
Yeah, maybe. And it's hard to tell if you're just tuning in. This is embossed tinfoil. or aluminum foil. I don't know what they call it. Oh, that's really pretty.
Okay, so I'm just going over and hitting those raised areas, and it's bringing out the color in there, which is really nice. And I'm kind of tapping just lightly so I get more color and less rub off. A little bit more. All right. So that's what it looks like if you could get it without the glare. There we go. Isn't that neat?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now I'm going to take some blue and I'm just go directly inside the raised areas. So I'm not doing this on top. And I'm just going to do that here and there. And with that same ink
tool. So you're putting the point of the dropper right down onto the tinfoil when you squeeze?
Correct. And because this is alcohol, you have to kind of move fast. So it dries really fast. So I'm just moving it around and getting some blue. And then, of course, that's mixing with the red, and we're getting some purple. So that's what we're getting. And I'm not sure if any of this is even visible for you guys because of the shine.
It looks a little bit like flashing neon light as the light catches the foil. Oh yeah, that's a good shot.
Okay, so now two things. One, you should probably put down your craft mat before you play, which I forgot. And have some alcohol handy to clean it up if you did. So I'm just going to pour some alcohol on my table here and wipe this up real quick before it becomes... Come on, Heather, you have tools. Use them. All right, so there we go. Just like that, all clean. Okay, now I'm going to let this dry because I want this to be... Let's see if I can get it so that you can see it. I want this to be dry so when I go to play with it, it won't come off. So we're going to set this over here, and we're going to mess around with some other pieces that I've already done. I did want to show you what happens if you don't use the waxed paper. Then when you put your even heavy-duty foil, when you put it through the embossing folder, it will rip it and tear it. So unless that was something you were going for, there's lots of little holes here. Crazy, huh? So here are some more sheets that I've done, that I have embossed, and now we're just gonna go to town with these, okay? Any comments out there you want to bring on screen?
Let's see, we've got Patty, who said that she loves to emboss foil, layers and layers of it. So do you just like to emboss it, Patty, or do you actually use it for something is what I want to know. Maybe she just likes to emboss it.
There you go. Good
and question. Then Tina suggested embossing the foil glued to cardstock. Now, of course, that wouldn't work for your project today, but would that still, that would make just like an embossed shiny card, right?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a really good idea. All right, I just remembered that I needed to put my craft sheet down. So, and bring up any of the comments that you see as we're doing this, because this is basically what I'm doing for the next 10 minutes probably.
All right,
I've got all these sheets to do, so.
Again, Andrew is sharing some suggestions. I asked how long it would take for that. What was this texture that you put on the mirror?
The 3D gloss gel.
Yes, 3D gloss. He suggested baking it at 225 for 15 minutes. I don't think that's a good idea.
No, I don't think so either. But it's a good suggestion. Thank you, Andrew. We're glad you're here.
He's always helping us.
You know what's really cool is he stopped in. Him and Michael both stopped in during our... Craft It Together this weekend we had on Saturday.
Tell me about Craft It Together. I couldn't get an internet connection.
Well, I thought it was a great time. We had a total of 12 people showed up, so that was really awesome. And we saw some new faces we've seen in the community before, but we've not ever been able to see in a Hangout before, so that was kind of cool. And of course, their names are escaping me right now, but maybe somebody in the Hangout right now knows and can put their names in for me. That'd be awesome. If you remember, I know Sherry was there, Tina was there, Sandra. So it was fun. It was fun.
Did anyone make anything special?
Did you happen to catch Sylvia's her latest Fast Craft Friday, which was something about making a wreath?
Yeah, I just watched that one, and then she also did another one with a denim on a journal cover. But yeah, I watched the wreath.
Okay, so the wreath one is the most recent one that she's done, and Kathy Gillette actually made one of those. I watched her make one of those, and it was so fast.
Was that the red and white one that got posted in the crafters community?
Yeah, so if you're in the crafters community, you've probably seen some of the pictures of what people have been doing. But yeah, exactly, it was beautiful.
And again, I'm always cognizant of the fact that some people could be watching on YouTube. So crafters community is a Google Plus community, and it's where this whole gang hangs out and, you know, posts pictures of our artwork. An awful lot of fun.
Exactly. All right, this is
so on Kraaft It Together, that's one Saturday a month, and this time it was the second Saturday of the month. It worked out better for everybody, but normally it's the first Saturday of the month, and not recorded session, but everyone comes in and has their cameras pointed at their workstations, on their workspaces, and some people are working on similar projects, but the times I've been in, everyone had sort of a different project going on, and we talk,
Speaking of that, Tina had the most exquisite mandala. She was drawing, you know, the Zentangling.
Uh-huh.
You missed it. That was, I know that's what you would have really loved to have seen.
Yeah, I'm a tangler, and maybe she'll post that in the community. I'll have to ask her about that.
Yeah, I hope so.
Tina, you're watching right now, as a matter of fact. So if you've got a photo, I'd love to see it.
All right. I'm doing some different techniques here where I've just added the blue directly to this pad, and now instead of maneuvering it around, I'm just... I love alcohol inks because you can do so many different things with it. So the look you get is totally different in how you apply it. You can rub it across and get a lighter image. Lighter strength of color. You can dab it, and if you put a couple of colors on one pad at the same time, they will kind of sort of blend together. So watch what happens. And I'm just dabbing it, and you can see that, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And see how they're just sort of blending together as we do that?
Yeah.
We did this once with tiles to make coasters and things.
So it looks like Patty is putting the embossed foil on cards and then cuts shapes and dies with a cuddle bug. And yeah. Sherry says that she's working on one today.
Awesome. That's great. I love that kind of stuff. I needed this to be foil because you're going to see what I do to the frame here in a bit. I needed it to be very flexible.
Oh, Nanette was putting some names into the comment stream here, and I was sitting here thinking, now what is she doing? But Dana S. and Jay were both at the Kraaft It Together. She's letting you know who was in attendance.
That's right. Thank you very much for that.
Was Jay working on a glass etching, or was he just hanging out?
Oh, my goodness, was he ever. He did a horse carving. It was a horse's head, and then the mane was like flowing swirls. Oh.
Ooh.
It was amazing. It was amazing. Okay. Now that I'm looking at the original piece that I made, I switched up my colors, but that's okay. We don't care. All right. So I'm just going to clean this up real quick, putting my caps on and putting that away so I don't have that big mess to clean up again. And a little bit of alcohol on my mat.
Oh, Sherry clarified. She's working on a wreath right now. So So in the crafters community under Fast Craft Friday, you can easily find Sylvia's video showing how to make wreaths out of tags. And it really, yeah, and then she did part of it all sped up. That was kind of fun to watch as the wreath came into being, you know.
All right. So I'm done with the alcohol inks for now. Now we're going to mess with our frame. So here's the frame that mirror piece came out of, and you can see that I kind of started with a piece, but it's the wrong color. So we're going to take that off, and I'm going to show you what I do. I have already pre-mixed a little bit of matte medium, a little bit of that matte gel. I mixed this with some water, basically two parts of gel to one part water to make it a little bit more liquidy so I can spread this on better. And I forgot I had a brush here. And I'm going to use this mixture, which is over on the side that you can't see.
And why don't you pull the camera back just a little bit?
Great minds. That's what I was working on.
Oh, okay.
All right. So here's the frame. And you can see it's a squared frame. And then that mirror that we put the stencil over, that will go inside here. And I just used for this particular frame, it came, can you see those, the staples that held it in?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I was able to just use a flathead screwdriver and bend those up, and it came right out. So just keep that in mind. So now I have two different patterns. Let's see if you can see these, if I can do this right. Two different patterns of embossed foil and these odd-shaped foils as well. So what I'm going to do is just kind of start over here in the corner, and it's still a little sticky because it's not fully dry, but that's okay. For the sake of the show, we will go on anyway. Now I'm just going to carefully bend it over because this is a molded frame here, so I'm just wanting to get it down into this using the back of my brush here. I'm just going to push it down in that corner. And then I'm going to do the same thing around the molded part here. And we'll lose some of that decorative. Thank you. Decorative molding here. We'll lose some of that, but we've got all this decoration on the foil, so it's okay. All right, and I'm going to fold it down and over and under here. Now I'm going to take it back up, and with just a pair of scissors, I'm going to trim that inside part off because we don't really want that to interfere with the mirror once we put the mirror back in. And all we're doing at this point is fitting it to the frame. And you do that by just, because it's foil, it'll just hold that shape, see? And notice that the embossed part is still there. I have not gotten rid of the embossing.
So when you're working with that foil, by pressing your fingers against it, that doesn't unemboss it?
Not really, no. Those rollers are pretty heavy, so you're not really dealing with getting rid of the embossing the way you think that you would be, because those rollers are stronger than your fingers are. Unless, you know, you manhandle it, I guess, but so far I'm doing okay, I think. All right, so this first piece is on there, but you know, you and I both know that's not going to stay. So that's where our mixture comes in. And See how light and fluffy that is now?
I just right, and that was two parts water or two parts matte gel?
Two parts of gel, one part water.
Got it. Okay.
All right, and now I'm going to carefully peel this off to not lose the shape, and then I'm just going to put a really thin layer about where that was. So we form first, then we glue. That's the key I wanted you to pick up on. Okay?
Sequence and process. Very important.
All right, so I'm just putting that back over the top of the glue, and it will hold it. Certainly not right at first. It's going to take a little while. But I've put none on the back here, so we're just going to flip it over a little bit. And the reason why I didn't do the back yet is because I wanted to make sure that I got most of it. Oh, I didn't get the side either. I wasn't paying attention to that part there. I didn't want to get the side all goopy and then lay it down and have it stick to the table. Okay? And we're just going to go all the way around with that. Now, because I have the two different patterns, I am going to use them alternatingly. So we'll have the one pattern and then this pattern, and I'm going to overlap them some in certain areas just so that way it will add to the character. And you'll notice I have these pieces that I've cut off. We're going to save those because we might need them to cover up some spots. Okay? So that's what I'm doing. Any more comments?
Well, Tina is going to finish her Zentangle in the After Crafter party. So are we going to be able to do After Crafter, I hope?
Absolutely. I think After Crafter would be a great idea.
Wonderful. And then, Tina, you know what? I'm going to bring my Zentangle into the After Crafter as well. And we can look at each other's work. Maybe I'll get some ideas. I've got a few spots in mind that I need to fill in. I was looking for some new ideas. So maybe I'll see something on Tina's that I can borrow.
Isn't that awesome?
Susan, yeah, it is awesome. I get so many tips from this group. They're so crafty, as you would say. would fill medium or matte medium stick to wax paper and make wax paper stick to something else? If so, there's no end to what could be done with the embossed wax paper in crafts.
Yeah, I would assume that you could probably glue anything with this matte medium because so far I've had nothing not stick. It just takes a while to dry. And especially if you add water to it like I did, it will take a lot longer to dry.
And I'm just jotting down names of folks who are asking to come into the after party, so I'll have that list ready for you, Heather. At the top of the hour.
Okay.
Did you want to talk about the open the box?
Oh, I do. Thank you. Yeah, so I got word today that my order will be here Friday sometime. This is the order for our Craft Shaak store. So that order will be here on Friday, which means on Friday, hopefully, if it comes early enough, I'll be able to do a open the box with you guys and show you what was in the box.
Wonderful.
Maybe we can show some of the products too. We'll see.
Yeah. Can I show a quick view of what's in the shop right now?
Oh, absolutely.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and try and screen share without. Oh, you might have to reach up and pin me, I think, right?
And sorry, you are now chosen. Go right ahead.
All right, then. Okay, so this is over in the shop, and then I just chose Art Supplies and Prima because that's where a lot of the stuff that Heather's using today is, I think. I was shopping before the show started, so I already moved my way through the shop. I'm on page 3. Let me see if I can back it up. And because I'm screen sharing, it's taking really long. Okay, so there's the 3D matte gel is in there. And did you also use 3D gloss gel?
I did for the part that we stenciled onto the mirror. That was gloss gel.
Okay, that was gloss gel. Okay, so that's in the store. And then you used this lace stencil that is in there, and I think there was something about sugar. I'm going to go look for that one too, because that looked really yummy.
Yeah, the art sugar is really awesome, and I do have some new items coming, some additional items coming in Friday's shipment, things that you guys haven't seen yet, some things that are just new colors. I've got a lot more stencils coming. That was something that was requested, was more stencils.
Yeah, and the stencils some more are cool. Some more sprays, did you say?
More sprays. I've got some flat sprays coming that are not glossy. For those who don't, glossy isn't the word, shiny. For those that don't like shimmer and shine, we're going to have some flat sprays that will allow you to have some of the same depth of color without the shimmer.
Alrighty. Okay. You can unscreen share me or unpin me or whatever you want to do over there.
Got it.
The shop is got a nice supply of stuff. You can keep pretty busy.
Yeah, we've even ordered some tools. So some people have asked for those water brushes that you can put the water in the tube and then have a brush on the go. Mm-hmm. I've got some of those coming too. And some items that we've never used on the show before, like Wink of Stella. You'll be excited to see that. It's like glitter in a pen.
Ooh, yeah. Wink of Stella. I love the names of names of some of these things.
Right, I agree. Okay, it's taken me a while to get this to form the way I want it to, so I apologize on that. I didn't expect it to take so long.
Now, what weight of tinfoil did you use on that, Heather?
It is heavy duty.
Okay.
That's what it says.
All right.
Whatever weight that is.
Because I know that there's some, like a really lightweight, they use it in delis, I think, and it feels pretty fragile, and I'm just wondering if it would be too fragile for this sort of thing, because it looks like you have to work it into the crevices.
Yeah, I would not use anything lighter weight than this, because I actually tried it with the regular foil that we have upstairs. This is my crafter's stash of foil, because this stuff needed to be molded. And I will tell you, if you're planning on making something like this, this is sticky because of the alcohol. So don't wash your hands until you're done. Or you could wear gloves, but what's the fun in that?
That would not be nearly as messy.
No. No.
Nor as fun. Yep. No.
All right, I'm just going to trim some of these parts out. This is really cool because you can just cut it with scissors. So cool.
And Tina is asking if they should just stay here for the aftercrafter. And yes, Tina, we'll just send you little invitations into the room. So just stay where you're at.
Exactly.
Oh, I just heard a big sheet of snow and ice come off my roof.
Oh, the snow, down. I tell you what, for those watching the replay, hopefully you're watching in the summertime and it's nice and cozy and warm where you are, but snow has fallen where I live, and it is now officially winter.
Yep, it's officially winter here, too. I'm in Colorado. I'm in the mountains right now, but I talked to a friend who's down in the city, and she said it was snowing down there, too.
Oh boy! So I knew it was coming. I think that's the worst part is when you know it's coming, you can't do anything about it. I mean, it's like just hurry up and prepare your area. Make sure your heater will turn on. You know, that kind of stuff.
Make sure your skis are tuned.
Oh well, there's Debbie's way of handling the winter. Make sure your skis are tuned. I can't say that I feel that way, Debbie.
I know. My friend called this morning, and her husband is going skiing tomorrow. So he's a ski racer, and he likes to get out there as often. The conditions aren't great yet here in Colorado, but they're getting there.
Wow. Can you hear how sticky that is?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I do love how it forms to the wood, though. It's working really well. It'd probably be working even better had I actually washed my hands. But
do you think so? I mean, they're just going to get sticky again, right?
Yeah, I don't know if it's the alcohol on my fingers that's sticky or if it's the alcohol on this that's sticky. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's the way I like to do things, you know, be as messy as it doesn't seem as fun if it's not as messy.
Now, after you get this all covered embossed foil, are you doing anything else to the frame?
Just putting, hopefully, the mirror in it, but I'm looking over there and I'm not seeing that it's dry.
Oh, darn it. Maybe that putting it in the oven for 15 minutes isn't a bad idea.
Yeah, exactly. I was just thinking that as I looked over. Yep.
Maybe you could just lay it over so we could get an idea of what it's going to look like.
That's kind of what I was thinking. I was thinking that, yeah. All right, we're almost done. We're rounding the corner now. The hardest part, I think, is trying to figure out how much foil you need ahead of time. Because I was trying to be prepared. You know, I know how much our Andrew likes that.
I was just going to say, I mean, you only did two pieces on air that we got to watch you do, right? You had the rest of it already prepared?
That I actually embossed. I only embossed the one, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because I had embossed a bunch of sheets when we were in the green room, you and I.
Oh, that's what you were doing. I heard the squeak, squeak. The cuddle bug, okay.
It's hard to tell sometimes what I'm doing over here when you're in here hanging out with me, huh?
We're pretty busy talking. I'm not much paying attention to what you're doing.
All right. So I'm thinking, as I'm doing this, I'm thinking that some of the edges are going to peel up because I haven't put anything under them. So I am wondering, and with how sticky it is, I'm wondering if I should put a coat of the gel medium over the top just to seal it all in.
Oh.
That'd probably make it easier to clean it up and wipe it off, huh?
Yeah, that would be, yeah, a nice coat. And what do they call it?
Like a sealant?
A sealant, yeah.
Yeah. Of course, I don't clean most of the time, so I don't know if it's really necessary, but probably is in other homes. Just not mine.
Well, dust is, I have one picture frame, you know, I put some just like gloss, whatever, urethane or whatever on it, and I forgot to do one of the frames that I put up, and that one isn't so easy to dust because of the, you know, the rough edge, the rough surface on it.
Yeah, that makes sense. So I guess we probably should seal it.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
We'll just pretend that I did. Camera. I won't make anybody sit through that part. This has already been somewhat excruciating. But
well,
you know,
go
ahead.
It's fun to watch it come together, though. I mean, I really. If you had only shown one or two pieces, that would have been difficult to see how it was all going to blend. It blends better than I expected it to.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I would have preferred to have done it all in one style now that I've got it this far. To be honest with you, I had 7 different embossing folders pulled out to do this.
Ooh.
And then I dropped down to 2 at the last minute when I was starting to put it all together in the green room. And I'm now wishing I would have just stuck with one. I think whatever pattern would have looked better all the way around and been easier, I think, to handle. Because where some of these meet, it looks glaringly obvious, and where some of them meet, it's not so bad. One more, and I don't have enough of this one.
Oh, you're kidding me. You don't have enough of those pieces?
Nope. And I could do this, I guess. And I could do this, and I could
ooh, almost.
This. I guess I can piece it together. That's going to take me a little while, though, so that might be for the aftercrafter party part.
Yeah, that would work.
That's going to take me a little while to piece it. So save those pieces. You want to keep those pieces. Maybe I'll just keep going. Let me check on the mirror. I'm walking over to check on the mirror here.
We can still hear you. Hey, I never heard your furnace turn on. I thought I was going to hear it.
It's been turning on and off, on and off. So there, I don't know if you can see, but it's starting to dry where the parts are. Oh, I bet you can't see that because it's a mirror. Can you see this one that's closest to me right here?
Yep, where it's
starting to dry, and that means it is actually turning translucent. Mm-hmm. So where it's going to be, it will actually be see-through. You'll be able to see through it. Just that color and the shimmer of the glitter will be left. Well, I guess that's something I should have had done ahead of time. I just wanted you guys to see me do it, though.
Well, hindsight is 20/20, Heather.
I know. And, you know, live crafting isn't always the greatest plan because so much of what we do when we craft is requires a lot of time. A lot of time and patience.
I'm going to put a little pressure on you.
Yeah, I know. I saw the clock. That's why I thought.
Yeah, we're going to alter the rest of the month. Do you know what you're going to alter next week, or is that going to come to you in your dreams?
You know what? I'm so glad that you asked that, because next week we have a special guest. I won't be altering anything, but our special guest will be altering something special that one lucky live viewer will win as a treat.
Ooh.
For doing it live. So this is exciting because our guest is Jay, our extraordinary glass etcher.
Oh, that is going to be so cool to watch. It sounds like it crafted together last Saturday. It was a great demonstration. I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, so he's going to be demonstrating how he engraves on glass, and he is going to be giving away what he makes to one lucky viewer. So I'm excited.
Oh, that's very cool.
And you know what? You can actually go register for that event right now. Well, not right now because you'll leave us. But, you know, after this is over, you could go register for that event and then leave a comment, a question, if you have any questions for Jay, because that's what he's going to be doing. He's going to be answering questions and showing us what he does.
Oh, that'll be very cool. So if you want to register, you just go over to the Kraaft Shaak website on the tab. And you'll see this month's programs are already scheduled, and you just click the little button and register for it. And then you can enter a room that allows you to leave comments. That's very cool. Or questions for Jay.
Yeah.
Particularly around glass etching.
Exactly. Yeah, it'll be fun.
Good. That'll be good.
All right. So where are we at on the time? Should I be saying goodbye?
You have 2 minutes, yeah. Oh. So you should probably wrap it up there, Miss Crafter.
All right. Well, I'm going to say goodbye. I'm going to say thank you, everyone, for joining us. I hope that you enjoyed altering a mirror with me. Not that we've completely finished it, but if you are looking for the finished version of this, you can either join us in the Crafters community, where I'm sure I'll post first, because I always post there first. And, of course, you can stick around for After Crafter Party, but those of you watching at a later date, that's just one more reason why you want to join live, because it's something we do. I know not everybody can watch live, so I don't want to say it like in a way that you've made a choice not to, but there are some who really wish that we did not do this show during their lunch or during their work time. But I guess we'll say goodbye. I'm still gluing. I can't say goodbye. I'm still gluing.
I know. Well, let us at least put that last piece on, because you are so close to being done.
I know. Okay. I am going to cover it with more. But there you go. What do you think?
Beautiful.
It's kind of cool. Oh,
yeah, it's kind of cool.
All right. I'm going to say goodbye, and we'll be seeing you in the After Crafter, or, of course, we'll be seeing you in the Crafters community, I hope. I hope you'll join us. We'll talk to you later, folks. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.